Hey, I'm gonna go ahead and install this Kidde brand FireX smoke alarm. It's a electric one. So we're actually gonna have to wire this baby up. Here's the directions for it. Comes in the bag. The part that we're gonna be wiring up is right here. And then this part is just actually gonna plug right into the back of there. So we'll go ahead and get this wired up. One thing to note too, this thing, it comes off of here. So we're gonna actually mount this. So it just twists off. Yeah, just twist that way. And then mount this, and then we'll run these wires. Actually, it'll be like that, that through there. And then these can come and mount and plug into the back of that. All right, let's get going. All right, here's what I'm working with here. Got some black wires, got some white ones. Looks like the ground's tied together there. Okay, you wanna make sure you kill the power to this thing and verify it. That means that one's still alive. All right, no power. Sweet, so now what I'm gonna do, is I'm gonna take these, I'm gonna incorporate the black wire with these black wires. Right there, and then I'm gonna put the white one in with these ones. Hey, whenever I pull old wiring off, I always look to see how the old stuff's looking. And this is looking pretty good. Still clean and shiny. You know, another good idea would be to take some sandpaper too there to make some really good connections. There we go. So what I like to do is screw these on until they're tight, super tight, and then check the wires to make sure none of them will pull out. Give it the old good pull test, and then I'll tape up around there just to keep this thing from coming loose or moving. Okay, that just snaps right on there. Okay, that just pulls right out of there. So that's for the backup battery. Let's go turn this on and see if it works. All right, it's gonna be loud if it works, so let's check it out and see. Let's test it out, ready? Push this button. Oh yeah, sweet. Okay, now I'm gonna turn the power back off. By the way, a little trick here, if you're removing this, you gotta push those in, so don't just try to pull it out, because it's kind of hard to see that when it's already hooked up. But yeah, push those just like that. Okay, gonna go ahead and install this baby. All right, the two holes that I'm gonna use for this is gonna be right there and right there. So I'm just gonna drill those out. There we go, drilled the two holes. Okay, just putting that through the middle there. I'm gonna line up my holes and screw them in. Okay, I got it screwed in. Now I'm just gonna plug it into the back here, turn the power on. Got it hooked up again. Again, like I said, if you wanna remove it, just push those together and pull it out. Now it just screws up into these tabs, those tabs right here and right there. They lock into there and then you just twist it. Push all the way up and turn. There we go. Hey, when I just put it on, I noticed I had some drooping. Well, I pulled it back off and I forgot to tighten that screw up all the way. So now, no gap around there. Pop it back on there. Much better. Okay, it's good news. If you got your green, that solid green light on, that means it's operating off of AC power like it should.